Welcome to the next session, children. Have you all started reading the story In the Kingdom of Fools by A.K. Ramanujan? How was the story? Did you all enjoy reading it? The story of fools sounds to be foolish in nature. Yes, without any doubt, it's like a story like that. So you would have read the story and I have explained you one half of the story. Today we are going to move into the next half of the story. Before going into the next half of the story, I would like to recall the things which we have seen in the previous class. Shall we have a recap of the previous things? Yes, we are going to have a short recap of the previous session. As I told you, this is a story from your supplementary book, that is Moments book, chapter 4. What is the title of the story? It is In the Kingdom of Fools. And you all know that it is written by a famous writer called A.K. Ramanujan. Did I tell you it is written by A.K. Ramanujan? Okay. And we have seen him as a Indian English writer. He holds the enduring fame as translating the works of classical poetry of Tamil into English. And as I have told you, translating is a very difficult job. Still, he holds that fame because of this translation work. Did you get to know about this poet A.K. Ramanujan? Or a great writer? He is not only a poet, he is a great writer who wrote stories, who wrote folk tales. I have introduced him to you. Did you get any extra information about the writer? Okay. So this is like a recap session of the previous class. We are seeing things and you know the story. It is In the Kingdom of Fools. What happens in the Kingdom of Fools? In the Kingdom of Fools, both the king and the ministers were idiots. Who were the idiots over there? The king and the minister were idiots. What happened when this is going on? What happens? So he orders his people to sleep during the daytime and he asked them to do all their business by the night time. This is the thing which happens in the story. Since he is a fool, the king is a fool, he wants everything to be done in a reverse. They did not want to run things like other kings. So they decided to change night into day and day into night. This is what happens in the story. A different rule which is framed by the king in order to make his people work by the night. And they have to take rest. They have to sleep during the daytime. The story begins like this, where you can see the character of a king is a goofy king. He is a foolish king. And when he is making rules according to his whims and fancies, I have explained you this term, whims and fancies, according to his own wishes, according to his own fantasies. There are ministers who are ready to follow him. And they even tell the people that if they are not going to obey the law, in case of disobedience, they'll be put to death. People, whoever is going to disobey the law, will be put to death. This is what the king tells here. Their weird rules range from waking up the entire night and sleeping through the day, throughout the day. You can make it there as throughout the day. To sell everything at the same price. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. You know the meaning of the word delighted. What is the meaning of the word delighted? They are happy about the success of their projects. Whatever steps they have taken now, they are happy about it. And here you can see that even the cattle had been taught to sleep by daytime. They not only trained the people to sleep by daytime, they also taught the cattle to sleep by daytime. When this happens, you can see. A guru and his disciple came to the kingdom of fools. The guru was a wise man and soon realized that it would be difficult to stay there for a long time. So he left the place. However, the disciple thought that it is right to stay there as everything was cheap in that place. Why did the disciple decide to stay there? He decided to stay there because he felt that everything is cheap in the place. And the disciple's main motive is to procure food items. What is the meaning of the word procuring food items? To get food items at cheap prices and eat as much as he can, which he did and gradually became very fat. So when the disciple got everything for a cheap price, and we have already seen that it is for a dudu, for a paisa. Things which he got from the city is very cheap. He ate everything, bananas, rice, everything, whatever he got it in a cheap manner, he ate everything. And the disciple became very fat. But the guru is not ready to stay in the place. Then what happens in the story? The fat disciple has become fat now. And here you can see that to their astonishment, they found the everything cost was the same. What is the meaning of the word astonishment? It was a great shock for them to find everything in a low cost. And it was of a single dudu. You could see there whether they bought a measure of the rice or bunch of bananas, it would cost only a dudu, not more than that. So this disciple is ready to stay there, and what was the consequence of it? When he is ready to stay, he became a fat man. Okay, he became a fat man. So this happens by one side. This happens by one side of the story. You can see that the guru will leave the city, and he will not stay in that city where it is called as the kingdom of fools. But this disciple, he stays in that city. The guru finally gave up and said, "Do what you want. I'm going." And he left the place. When the disciple is not ready to accompany the guru, this is the wisest statement uttered by the guru. What did he say? Do what you want. You be in the city, you get everything for cheap price and eat everything. I'm not ready to stay here because I realize that this is the kingdom of fools. So he is not ready to stay there. He leaves the place. And you could see that they are all fools. This won't last very long. You can't tell what they'll do to you next. See, this is the warning given by the guru when he left the place. You wish to stay in this place. The guru is telling like this. He is talking to his disciple and he is telling, you wish to stay in this place. But I can find that they are all fools. And they will create some trouble to you. They all seem to be like fools. They'll create some trouble to you. And this won't last for a very long time. They will do something. They will cause trouble to you. It is better to leave the place. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, ate his food every day. He filled his tummy. He ate bananas, ghee, rice, wheat, and grew fat like a street side sacred bull. See the comparison made, children. He ate everything and he grew bigger in size. And he looked like a fat street side bull. Okay, this is what is happening. And when this is happening, one bright day, we all know that in the kingdom of fools, people used to sleep by daytime. So one bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. A thief entered into a rich merchant's house. He made a hole in the wall. And how he entered? He made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. What is the meaning of the word sneaking in? Entering, okay. Entering in, he sneaked in means, we will say that a snake sneaked in, okay, just without any noise, sneaked in. And as he was carrying out his loot, what is called loot, children? The things which he has looted from the family, the wealth which he is taking it out, the things, okay. He is coming out with the things which he has looted. The wall of the old house collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. What happened? The wall of the old house collapsed. Since he made a hole in the wall, when he entered, he was the only person to enter. But when he returned, he came out with all his things. He came out with all his things. So it disturbed the wall. And the entire wall fall on his head. It got collapsed and it fall on his head and killed him on the spot. So when the thief was dead, the news was taken by his brother to the king, and you could find that the thief's brother will ask the king for justice. This is what I asked you to read in the story. You could see that different characters will come. When the thief's brother asks the king for justice, he will call that merchant, okay, the rich merchant, because it is the thing, the wall of his house fall on his head and it killed him. You can see the rich merchant will blame the bricklayer. You know the bricklayer, the one who built the house. And this bricklayer will have an interesting story to blame the dancing girl. Read the story, children. I'll not explain you. You can see that the merchant will blame the bricklayer, whereas the bricklayer will blame the dancing girl. And thereby you can see that the dancing girl will blame the goldsmith. Okay, the goldsmith will be blamed. And finally, the goldsmith will blame the old merchant. Who is that old merchant? The old merchant is the owner of the house. You are going to tell me after the session. This is a homework for you. Read the story. And you are going to write the reason. What is the reason? The bricklayer will blame the girl. And the dancing girl will blame the goldsmith. You have to list down. You are going to list out the reasons why they just put the blame on others. Will you do it? Yes. So once they start blaming everyone, now you can find that a stake will be waiting over there. Okay, a stake, the machine which is used to cut, okay, which is going to murder the one who has done the thing. It will be waiting over there. And finally, a man will be decided by them to put them under a stake. And who is that? It is the disciple who came with the guru. Read the story, children. See, I am not narrating you the full story. Just here and there I am highlighting the ideas. So when you read the story, you will come to know. You will get the real essence of the story. Is it clear for everyone? Keep reading the story. And you are going to tell me, what is the reason the bricklayer blamed the dancing girl? And why did the dancing girl blame the goldsmith? There are reasons behind it. Read the story and give me the reason.